Yeah, whoa. Yeah. That's good. A nice, dark shape. We had a couple of calves out there and couldn't get him on the neck. So what I did, I'll show you when we landed. A lovely ground. Great ground there, and I'll show you on an egg pattern that we have got from America that we learnt from some of the guys when we were fishing Alaska. But if you have a look at that fish there, you can see that, probably that egg pattern just on the side of his jaw there. It's a lovely brown. It's very dark. As you can see by the colour there, he's come up ready to spawn. I'll just put a bit of pressure on him. Get that net under. And a lovely fish there. That's beautiful. So that's a good start to the day here. And it's open for an extra month because it has a high percentage of rainbows as well, which spawn a bit later. So still holds a lot of good browns like this one as well. So that's a pretty good start. And I'll show you this egg pattern. And it's a great place to spend a bit of time over in New Zealand. What we want to try and do is keep his gills in the water and oxygen going through for most of the time. So if you're going to take a photo, get everything ready and then quick pick him up and then let him go. But a wonderful fish. Very dark, just stunning colours, ready for spawning. Just a bit over 4.25 pounds. And he's got plenty of go left in him, so that's pretty good. So the setup we're using is at the moment I've got like a dry fly, and I'll use that for two things. They still will have like caddis hatches and things like that, so I'll eat like that's a stimulator, like a rubber leg royal stimulator, which I use very often. And on this we have a little bead, which looks like a trout egg. And that floats down, and underneath that is a little nymph. So I'll see this bead, eat it, I'll strike when that indicator goes down, and the nymph will either hook them, or they could well even eat that nymph. It sort of doubles your chances. But if it works, all well and good. Hopefully there's another one upstream as well.